The Attorney General has refused to apologise for the automated debt recovery scheme, which the government now admits was unlawful. The Commonwealth will now have to repay more than $700 million to welfare recipients. But with legal action looming, that bill could go higher.
No matter how you say it,
it's a very unfortunate outcome. The basis upon which the debts were being raised was insufficient. Civilly, it was unlawful.
The Commonwealth now admits its automated welfare debt recovery system was illegal.
There wasn't a lawful basis, that's what it means.
From 2016 to November last year, robo-debt generated letters demanding welfare recipients prove they hadn't been overpaid, based solely on average income data generated by the Australian Tax Office.
An unlawful, unjust scheme, chasing hundreds of thousands of innocent Australians for debts they didn't owe.
Like Nadia Sievright, who was a nursing student caring for her disabled mother when she got a letter of demand.
To get hit with $22,000, it was money that I'd never seen and never dreamed of seeing in my life.
470,000 debts raised using income averaging will have to be repaid, and that's expected to cost $721 million.
Well, we're refunding everyone who has been part of the compliance system using income averaging.
But the stress the demand for repayments put on the poor can't be measured in cash alone.
I can't pay this $22,000. I mean, what do I do now? I did think about suicide.
This government acted like a legalised mafia, shaking down vulnerable people.
But the minister who once presided over the scheme won't apologise for it because that could drive the cost of redress even higher.
Well, the system was flawed. I'm not going to use that word because there's litigation ongoing.
And that class action could push the final payout beyond $1 billion. Chris Yulman, 9 News.